الله ربي واحد وأنا بذلك أشهد.
In Britain, we are facing one big problem, and it's getting worse day by day. Very rarely we used to hear this question about 20 years ago when I came to this country, that are you Muslim or British? This clash of identity here. Now we are asked this question, and not we are only asked, we are asked to prove it. That's and in future it will go worse. So how and what would be your advice to all the Muslims who are living in Britain? Majority of them are British passport holders.
That's a common question asked that in this country, that are you a Muslim first or British first? In India, back home, they ask, are you a Muslim first or Indian first? And we Muslims should know how to reply, how to turn the tables over. If someone asks you, are you a British first or a Muslim first, you have to ask that gentleman, are you a man first or are you a British first? Mm-hmm. Ask him a counter question.
Yes, sir.
But naturally the reply will be, he's a man first. Because even if he goes to America, if he takes the citizenship of America, he'll yet be a man. If he goes to Australia, yet he'll be a man. So similarly, we are first Muslim and then British. But only giving this answer without posing the counter question, they may not understand. If we say we're Muslim first and then British, they'll say, oh, that means anti-national. So you have to ask them the question, are you man first or a British first? So just because he says that I'm a man first, that doesn't mean he's anti-British or he's anti-national. Mm-hmm. And we should realize that we are Muslim first because we have allegiance to our Creator, Almighty God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has given us this life, this body, all this ni'amah, all these facilities. So but natural, we have allegiance to him. Same way, we also have to be loyal to the country. But if the law of country, if a person is a man and a British, but man first then British, if that country, whichever country it may be, if it goes against humanity, that human being will first follow the law of humanity and then that country. Similarly, since we have to lay allegiance to our Creator who has given us everything in this world, our first allegiance goes to our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then to this country. As long as that country doesn't go against the law and guidance laid down by Almighty God, we have to follow the laws of the country. If there's a clash, the law of Almighty God, like a law of humanity, takes precedence to the law of the country. Mm-hmm. But the same question if you ask to a Saudi, are you a Muslim first, a Saudi first? Even he'll give the reply, I'm a Muslim first, then a Saudi. If you ask a Kuwaiti, are you a Muslim first or Kuwaiti first? The answer is he's a Muslim first, then Kuwaiti. That does not mean that that person is against Saudi Arabia or that person is against Kuwait. So we should know how to turn the tables over and give the reply. We should be satisfied. Giving a reply is easy, but giving a satisfactory reply is the point that is important.